In this lesson, we're going to discuss auto recovery in InDesign. If you'd like to follow along, go under the File menu to Open, and in the Sample Files folder, open 0202, The Magic of Auto Recovery. Just click Open. Whenever you open an InDesign document, an IDLK file is created in the same folder as the layout. Why don't we take a look? Go to File Open again. And in the Sample Files folder, you can see at the very top, there's a file with a very similar name as our layout, but it has some code and then .idlk at the end. Let me hit Cancel. Most users assume that this is the auto recovery file. Well, it's not. It's actually an InDesign lock file. This locks the file so no other user can open it across a network. It's protecting the file. The real auto recovery file is in InDesign's auto recovery folder, deep in the bowels of InDesign. It is saving all the steps that you make once every minute. So if the power goes out, or you have a computer problem that forces InDesign to quit, you'll never lose more than 1 minute of work. Let's say that InDesign quit right now. You could restart InDesign, and the recovery process begins automatically. A dialog window will open to ask if you want to start automatic recovery. And of course you do, so in the dialog window, you just press OK, and the InDesign file will open right away on the same page that you were working on when InDesign had to quit. And you'll never lose more than a minute of work. Most of the time, you don't lose any work. But recovery is not the only purpose of this temporary file. This data file is keeping track of everything that you do as you're working. This allows you to undo an unlimited number of times, all the way back to where you first opened the document. Why don't we try something? Let's go to the black arrow, which is the selection tool, and just click on the headline and drag it someplace else. And now drag it another place. And maybe I will draw a rectangle. So I went to my rectangle tool and just clicked and dragged with the tool. Maybe I want to add a fill. Well, there's a fill color pop-up, kind of a back door into the swatches panel in the control panel. Okay, let's undo everything that we just did. I'm going to hit Command-Z on a Mac, Control-Z on a PC. Every time I press the command, it undoes another step until I get back to where I first started when I opened the document. But what if I went too far? Is there a way to go forward? Well, I always say you have to shift into reverse. So instead of hitting Command-Z or Control-Z, you add a shift to that command. So it's Command-Shift-Z or Control-Shift-Z. And you can see it's moving one step forward every time I press the command. It would do this even if I've saved multiple times between those steps. It's almost as if you're going back in time. But unlike the movie Back to the Future, I know I won't disturb the time-space continuum. At least I hope not. In the next lesson, we're going to continue talking about the basics of InDesign.